I was able to save a lot. I ended up paying just a third of what the first garage said to me. Hi there, welcome back to the Phoebe Way. The Phoebe Way, this channel, is all about life in Germany, making life in Germany easier for expats coming to Germany from all over the world. So if you have any questions about life in Germany, social issues, legal issues, I'm your girl, I'm your plug. I'm Phoebe, nice to meet you. If you're new to this channel, please do well to subscribe, activate the notification button so that anytime I upload a video about life in Germany, you'll be one of the first to know and you'll be notified, okay? Let's get into today's video without further ado. Today's video is about how to save in Germany. It is a good thing and it is not always going to be easy. So I'm going to share some practical tips with you so you're able to achieve this goal. If you're not in Germany, these tips actually apply to you as well. Just as some of the websites that I'll be sharing later might not apply to you. So you would have to do the research to know which websites or which ideas you can apply to your life or what you should find or the equivalent, basically the equivalent website in your country of residence, okay? So guys, let us get into it. You want to save, how do you do it? Number one, obviously you need a plan. You need to budget, okay? You need to have an overview of your finances. So first, you know how much you're getting in, that's your income, how much you are spending, how much you're paying, how much is leaving your account. And then you have to also determine how much you want to save and how much you'll be able to save, all right? Also stay realistic, okay? Stay realistic. So plan. So in order for you to stick to your budget and actually achieve your goals, I would advise that when it comes to the budget, you know how much are your fixed costs, so the cost that you actually have to pay every month, costs that you also don't have a lot of power to influence at this moment. These are your, I would say, long-term fixed costs, so like your rent, electricity bill, and all of that. They are normally in Germany, they're normally not done. In Germany, these costs like rent and or electricity bills, they're actually fixed, and at the end of the year, you have to pay the difference or they return the difference to you. So normally it's the same amount you're paying every month, okay? So determine these costs, and then you have the costs that you can actually influence. So what you eat, what you wear, and all of that. These are the costs that you can influence, that you can say, okay, I can minimize this, I can cut these costs, I can reduce these costs. These costs are the ones that we are going to dwell on today more. And at the end of the video, we'll talk about the other costs as well. But let's talk about these flexible costs first, okay? So, as I said, make a budget. Number two is that you have to know that in order for you to save money, you have to invest time to acquire the knowledge, to make the research, to know where are the offers, where are the discounts, how do I save, and all of that. So you have to actually, and when do I buy? When do I make the purchases? So you have to actually make time in order to save money. Okay, so invest time to save money. Good. It will make sense to you as I explain. So now let's come to these variable costs or these flexible costs, okay, for lack of better expression. So how do you minimize your cost for food? How do you minimize your cost for food? Number one is try the discounters. So Lidl, Netto, Aldi, Norma, Penny. These shops are usually the ones with the lower prices, okay? Go to these shops and save. And as you go into these shops, they might have two or three options for one product. How do you know how you're actually saving? Because sometimes the lesser price is not really good for you. So let's say I need something like sugar. Maybe the 100 gram from this brand is 250, but the 500 gram is actually 329. How do you know what is cheaper? You have to go by the unit price. So 100 grams, you go by the price per 100 grams. So sometimes by weight, sometimes by size, sometimes by liter. Just go by the unit, okay? That is how you actually know how much you're going to save or how much you are saving, okay? That is one thing. So if you know it's something that you'll be using often, it's something that you'll be needing, and it's not something that is perishable, something like sugar, you can actually store for a longer period. You buy the bigger size or you buy it in bulk and you keep it, okay? But you have to stay realistic, as I said earlier. Stay realistic in what you actually buy. And because you have a budget, you're not going to be doing impulse buying, right? That's another thing. Budgeting helps you with impulse buying, so you have to exercise self-discipline and stick to what you're allowed to spend, okay? Good. So let's go back to the shop. Now, you want to know, where are the offers? In Germany, it is quite easy. Most of the time, we get the offers sent to us to the house, so you have all these newsletters, like paper that is sent to your mail. You can actually open your letterbox and see all of these. Or some people have actually told the people not to give it to them. So if you have that kind of mailbox, sorry, but not all hope is lost. You just go online and whatever shop is close to you or whatever shop you want to shop in, you just say Angebote von maybe Kaufland, Angebote Edeka, Angebote Lidl, Angebote, you know, and they'll show you those offers for the week. And if you don't even know how to plan your meals or what to eat for the week, this is how you do. You check what is on offer, you check what is cheaper for the week, and you plan your meals around that, okay, compared to what you already have. And then so you know, you consider what you already have, and then you see what is actually on offer, and then you combine that and you save the money, all right? That is one thing you can do. Always keeping in mind that you actually do compare. That's why I said you need to spend time, okay? You need time to be able to save money. Good. So you go in there, you check the offers. Another thing with grocery shopping is that you can also choose to use the apps. So most of the shops have apps, like Lidl has the Lidl Plus app or Lidl Plus app. Once you actually sign up, you get 5 euros off your first purchase, right? So just try it. I love it because every week you get something for free. Every week, it could be a yogurt, it could be something. Just try it. And as I said, budgeting helps you to control your impulse buying. It should also let you know that the fact that the thing is on sale or on offer doesn't mean that you have to get it if you don't need it, okay? And some offers are actually made to want you buy more. Don't buy what you do not need. Sometimes some offers would be like, buy 3 for 2. And you know that it's a perishable product, you can't use it all, then please buy what you can use. If you actually know someone you can share with, then you can buy. So another thing too is, share with others, share the cost, split the cost, okay? That also, talking about food. No, I've been talking about grocery, because obviously that's the one of the best ways for you to save money. You cannot be eating out, ordering pizza every day. Hello. That can like heighten your expenses by like 5 times. Don't do it. Try to cook as much as you can. How to plan your meals ahead of time for the week. That's how you save the money. And try as much as possible to make the meals by yourself and minimize the amount of times that you actually eat outside, okay? That is one golden nugget with saving. You need to just take your food with you to work. You need to try as much as possible not to eat out. It is what it is. Try as much as possible not to eat out. Try as much as possible to take control of how and what you spend by making food by yourself. And there are also apps. In case you want to eat out still, there are actually some apps that would help you. There's one in Germany called Too Good To Go. Too Good To Go is an app that has restaurants, even grocery stores, bakeries that are actually offering food at a discounted price. Okay, so try that app if you want to eat out and you want to save money, like a lot of money. Sometimes you pay $3.50, $3.90, around that. And even some of the grocery stores will give you a lot of fruit and veggies for $3.90, $3.50. So sign up, download this app, sign up and see what is around your area so you can save. If you're in a different country, try and see if there are similar apps or if Too Good To Go actually works in your country. I know it works in other countries, so check out those other countries or check out whether this app actually works in your country as well. So Too Good To Go is one app. Talking about apps, apps are not only for food, but there are actually things that some apps are good for. So apps for budgeting, apps for getting free stuff. So even if you are going to eat at Subway, download the app so you can get the 10th sub for free. You can get a free coffee or something. These things, you think it's nothing. By the end of the year, you realize that, oh, you've actually saved something. 10%. It's a lot. It is a lot. So try and download the apps and let these apps work for you, okay? And make sure you take advantage of the free stuff. Yes. you don't always have to spend money in your leisure time, okay? So you don't always have to buy books. Just go get the subscription or the membership at the library. If you're a student, for example, you get the subscription and you get books for free, you just have to return them. The thing is, you don't even have the space to be buying books all the time. So buy only books that you really, really like. Even for your education, you don't have to buy every textbook. Go to the library and borrow these books, okay? Save money like this. I don't remember the last time I bought certain books because in law, something new is coming every year. Every year, don't expect me to have every edition of every book that I need. I get them from the library and that's it. That's it. When it comes to software as well, check with the university because sometimes they have licenses for students. You don't have to buy everything and pay everything out of your own pocket, okay? Try and see. As a student, for example, there are some things that are made for you. So when it comes to phone bill, when it comes to phone contracts or telecommunication contracts, please check what offers they have for students. Check for offers they have for people under 25 and all of that. So check those and take great advantage of them, please. And then as I talked about budgeting, you are thinking, how do I keep my budget? How do I control what I spend? You can actually start a new account. And then with this account, it is just for your expenses. So you have one that has your income, one for your savings, and one for your expenses. So every week you put money on this account, and that is the card that you carry with you. So the big card or the card with the big money stays home, right? And preferably the card with the big money should stay out of reach, all right? And your savings account shouldn't be an account that you can have easy access to be spending the money on top, okay? So that should be something like a Sparkonto, like a savings account, a real savings account. And then the spending account should be like a Girokonto. And you can actually get Girokontos for free, like no rates at all, no service rates. So please look into all of these. As I said, you need to take the time to make the research to know where the good offers are. I'll give you a tip on the good offers. Just keep watching. So make sure you go for the free versions of everything that you can get. And even if it's not totally free, you don't always have to be in the bar with your friends. Get the drinks from the grocery store and sit down in the park. The weather is about to get better. Sit down in the park and talk. And I'm sure that hopefully by summer, we can actually meet like in bigger groups outside as well. So 3, 4, 5 friends can sit outside and, you know, have a nice conversation, have a good time. And taking a stroll is for free, honey. When it comes to transportation, it's not something that you can actually dodge. So if you have the means of buying a bike, you can actually buy one. You don't need a brand new bike or an expensive bike or an e-bike specifically, but just a bike to get you around is fine. And sometimes cars are actually extra cost. It is what it is. It is what it is. So bike, or if you want to be using the public transportation more often, you should consider getting a monthly subscription or the yearly subscription, because with that you save a lot. And even though they get on our nerves sometimes, most of the time it actually works. The transport system works. Educate yourself on the options that they have or the offers that they have for different kinds of people, because there are some people who don't leave the house until it's like 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. For such a person, you get the discounted price. It's like the 9 o'clock ticket or 9 o'clock ticket. Talking about taking control of those fixed costs, right? Or those costs that actually come every month or every year. Listen, there are these two websites that tell you the differences between the offers that some of these companies have. So let's talk about insurance, telecommunications, so phone services. Let's talk about electricity bills. Let's talk about gas. All these things that normally you think that they are binding contracts for, like for a long time. Of course, it depends. Some contracts go 12 months, 24 months, and all of that. But if you know when your contract ends, you should be able to have a fair idea of whether you're going to change or not. And how do you do that? You have to compare prices to know. And for that, you have to check on these websites, verivox.de or checkfilmsvantage.de or check24.de. Yeah, check24.de or verivox.de. So these are the websites that you can check and see whether things have actually gotten cheaper for you or not. And yes, your circumstances can change. They can change, but please look into it if you can actually, you know, adjust some things and get a cheaper deal from a different company, all right? You don't have to stick with one company. Sometimes you can save hundreds of euros just because you change. And for me, I am going to be doing it for this year because my car insurance is about to expire. And if I don't do anything, they will just continue because... But if I do find a cheaper offer, I am going to change because I still am within that time frame of changing. So please be aware of the details of your contracts and know when you can change, all right? A lot of people do not know this, but claim your tax returns. If you have been working and you have been paying tax, don't give all the money to the state. Take what is yours back, okay? Sometimes you can get up to 800. Some people get way more on their tax returns. It depends on how much they were earning, how much they paid, how much deductions they had. So it depends whether you had expenses due to work. It depends if you had medical expenses. Depends. But please, please, please look into it and claim your tax returns. And if you don't know how to go about that, there are numerous websites that are helping people. If you don't know what to do, look for a tax advisor. If you want me to do a video on taxes and where you should go to, please say that in the comment section down below. I'll definitely do a video on taxes. I've talked about splitting with people, and that's, I always say connect, connect, connect. Connection is so, so important. Connect with people because not only will you be splitting costs, but also you can just ask people who you know and who you can trust, hey, I have this situation, where can I get it done at a cheaper price? I'm saying this out of experience. I just got my car repaired, and if I hadn't talked to anybody, I'll just go to the Mercedes store and have them do it. But because we ask other people about their opinions and where they have been or who does their cars for them and everything, I was able to save a lot. I ended up paying just a third of what the first garage said to me, and I was probably going to do it, but now I paid just a third of it. So please, please, please ask your neighbors, ask your friends, hey, I have the situation, where did you get yours done, where did you buy this, where did you buy that? Okay, so make the comparisons and please ask other people as well. The last but not the least, I've seen this trend a lot with people who come to Germany to study, for example. Please, before you choose your university, make sure you know the kind of city you're going to study in. Is this place affordable for me? Not just the uni being free, but what about the city? Is the city affordable for me to live in? Can I pay rent? What is the average cost of rent? Or what's the average cost for a square meter in this area? Okay, so sometimes Stuttgart is Stuttgart, but if you're living in a place like close to the airport, it's going to be more expensive. If you're living somewhere like way away from Stuttgart, where you can still reach Stuttgart by the S-Bahn or by the regular trains, please try and consider all these things so you know what you're ready to forfeit. Are you ready to forfeit the short time travel to save more and more money? Will you use the travel time to university to actually read or revise your notes or what? Know what will work for you, what you're willing to sacrifice in order for you to save, okay? So before you come to Germany, check the cities as well. Check the cost of living of the city that you plan to go to, okay? So that you will not be surprised, like negatively surprised. So please, please, please check that before you get overwhelmed. And then also, if you're trying to save money and your budget is not allowing you to save a lot, you have to just increase your income. It is what it is. What is coming in has to just be higher in order for you to be able to put more aside, okay? So you either start a side hustle, so you get a part-time job, or you yourself start offering services for things that you are good at. Don't sleep on your talent, too. Do not sleep on your talent. I was sleeping on my talent of languages for a long time before I realized that I could actually make a lot of money by speaking Pidgin English, by speaking Fanti, by speaking Chi. But please, please, just do not sleep on your talent. Try to make something out of it. And the thing is, time is money, as I said. As you are investing time in seeking out the offers and all of that and planning where to buy what and when to buy what, also take time to find a job that is going to pay you well for the time that you are spending there, okay? Yes, so guys, we have come to the end of today's video. I hope you have learned something today. If you have, please give this video a thumbs up. And I'll be so glad to answer your questions, to read your comments down below as well. Let me know what you want to see next. And Have I said everything? Check out my other videos as well. And guys, please take good care of yourselves. Keep your mask on, keep your distance, and stay positive, stay hopeful. This next is on Talk Money Leading. Cheers.